Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube. And if you like railroad roundhouses, you're gonna love this video. Because I found two that most people don't even realize are still around. They're both former Pittsburgh and Lake Erie Railroad, about 100 miles apart. The first one we're gonna look at is in Newell, Pennsylvania. Located alongside the Monongahela River, where we still see barge traffic. This was the former P&LE yard. And a very little known roundhouse still exists. So let's take a closer look. Alright, so I spent a lot of time on the internet trying to find as much information about this roundhouse as possible, and I'm not gonna lie, there is hardly anything. I did find some pictures from 2012 that someone took of the inside, and I'll show you that in a little bit. But let's take a look at what we can find out now as modern day archaeologists. This is part of the hobby that I think so many people just miss, is finding these old buildings and then trying to do some research and kind of imagine how things used to be. So looking at what we have here, we could tell first that there's still 5 stalls remaining out of a possible 15. I always tell you that railroads have no money to be made by busting up concrete. They're going to recycle the ties, recycle the rail, but they're not going to spend the money on the concrete. So that's why you'll find concrete remnants everywhere. They're easy things to model. Now we can imagine how big that turntable would have been. And older people that worked for the railroad have told me that this in the last years of the P&LE might have been used for car repair. Newell now is only like 4 tracks with crossovers that's used for the staging of coal trains. And I'll talk about staging in another video. So this is Henwell. Now for CSX, when we're working here, we come off what's known as the chemical lead, and then we simply pull up the chemical lead with one car and set it over. I don't see any engines with Henwell. I believe they just use some type of machinery just to grab the car and then bring it in to one of these tracks. This is the first time I've been able to see inside the corporation and see that some of the tank cars have been here for quite a long time. Now we only give them a car maybe once every few days, maybe once a week. But this also shows that roundhouses today, if they're not gonna be used for railroad purposes, can be used for storage. And let's look at their roof. One of the things they did was repair the roof. And instead of making the building curved, they angled the front. And you could tell by the roof. Now, if you have a roundhouse that you're building and you want to modernize it, this is simple styrene that you can get to match. And let's take a look at the back. So it's very well maintained. And just something that you can incorporate into your modern layouts is to still have that roundhouse, but just kind of modernize it and use it for storage for another facility. Tell a story with your layout. Now let's take a look inside. Back in 2012, if you go on Flickr and find Evan Williams, he has a Flickr page where he went inside and took pictures long before they remodeled this place. Pause the video and just look at this structure. It was pretty neat back in the day. Now let's go to another Pittsburgh and Lake Erie roundhouse about 100 miles away. This is in the town of Newcastle. So here's a cool shot of the Newcastle Junction and the Pittsburgh and Lake Erie crossing over diamonds. to get from the car shops, the old roundhouse. Not much has changed. That roundhouse is 5 stalls. I believe it always was. We'll look at an old map. Now the turntable obviously is gone, and they kept rearranging the track. And you can just, if you look closely, pause the video. If you got like a big screen, you can zoom in on some of these details. Because there's rails going in different directions, real tight radiuses. It's really cool up here. Now the track to your right is for the New Castle Industrial Railroad. And they will bring the cars to CSX. CSX does not come in here. The New Castle Industrial Railroad will deliver any cars from Casgrove to CSX. Just one big roll-up door, and you can store whatever you want in here. So how cool is this? I mean, look at all the little details, things that you can model today. This is filmed in April in 2022. Now I'm going to do a video very soon about Casgrove and about the Schnabel cars, because they make some really cool stuff. There we see CSX westbound. And of course, the Pittsburgh and Lake Erie Diamond is long gone. A lot of switches, some tight curves. And I don't know if you could tell this old map, but if you can look closely, you can see that there was a turntable for the roundhouse, and the roundhouse looks like it was still about 5 stalls. So Newcastle Junction, somewhere that still has a roundhouse, 100 miles away from the one down in Newell. So one last look, and be sure to subscribe to this channel, DJ's Trains, because you're going to love the video on Schnabel cars. That's coming really soon. A lot of great stuff, so subscribe. Also, if you want to interact with me directly, go through the Patreon page. And you can follow me on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. A lot of cool stuff. I'll be doing some traveling. The month of May is going to be fantastic. So thanks for watching. Bye-bye.